Micro Lecture 40, The Multipolar World. After the fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989, the Soviet system disintegrated and the victory of liberal democracy seemed to be clear. As a political and economic philosophy, liberal democracy promised the development of society, peace, security, and progress. However, the real effectiveness of this ideology has had many limits. Despite delivering unprecedented global prosperity since World War II, liberal democracy has increased social inequality and a massive wealth disparity between nations and regions. Consequently, liberal democracy has been met with a growing range of social activism that fights to reduce social inequality, racial, gender, and ethnic discrimination and marginalization and the planet's environmental destruction. The tension between liberal democracy and social activism is an example of the many contradictions that have shaped the contemporary world. On a planet with more than 7 billion people, the population has increased its demands for more food production, sustainable development, healthcare, education, water resources, and technology. When these grievances are not met, protests and resistance emerge. To understand the globalized world that emerged after the end of the Cold War is vital to consider three very distinctive elements: migration, urbanization, and the fortification of multinational corporations. Immigration policies vary considerably around the world. In Europe, the consolidation of the Union allowed the free movement of European citizens within the continent. However, non-EU citizens have seen an increase in the barriers to move and circulate. The migratory crisis is more evident in the Mediterranean Sea, where thousands of African migrants die every year trying to cross to the European continent. The southern border of the United States is perhaps the one that best illustrates the contemporary world's migratory problems. Since long before a border exists between the United States and Mexico, migrants have circulated throughout North America. Still, after the U.S. took possession of its southern territories after the Mexican-American War, the population movement has been restricted. At the beginning of the 21st century, those restrictions include building a wall despite a free trade agreement that allowed the circulation of goods and capital across the border. Fed by nationalist sentiments and white nationalist rhetoric, the border has emerged as a site of political contention. The patterns of migration and the policies against people's circulation reflect the unevenness of wealth distribution at the international, regional, and local levels. The pursuit of economic opportunities and security has forced millions of people to move across frontiers or within national borders. Migrants usually become ethnic, religious, or linguistic minorities in the countries or cities where they settle, and they commonly face discrimination, persecution, and criminalization. Urbanization is another crucial element that explains how the contemporary world has been shaped during the last 30 years. Cities in Africa, Asia, and Latin America have grown at an astonishing pace since 1945. Many modern cities have doubled or even tripled their size in the last few decades. In 1950, there were only 8 megacities, 5 million or more inhabitants, and only 2 were in the global south. Now, there are 37 megacities globally with more than 10 million people, and most of them are outside Europe and the United States. Several reasons explain the urban explosion. There is more population growth, and urban dwellers have access to better healthcare. There is more migration, more food production, and more mechanized production in the countryside. Most of these megacities are inhabited by urban poor who have a precarious living environment and are dependent on informal economies made up of petty traders and unskilled laborers. There are violent chains of exploitation in these economies, and regular salaried jobs are rare and highly prized. In these spaces, a complex world of tiny, unregulated business and service occupations predominate. In cities, the concentration of wealth in few hands has resulted in unequal consumption patterns, lack of education, and unemployment. The gap between rich and poor has grown exponentially. More often than not, wealthy people in these cities have more things in common with other rich city inhabitants worldwide than with poor people in their own countries. The final element that should be mentioned as characteristic of the contemporary world is the existence of multinational corporations. This type of businesses emerged globally after the 1950s and since then had managed to dominate essential sectors of the world's economy. Multinationals operate in several different countries and tend to adopt a global rather than a national perspective. The increase in international economic relations and the drive for rapid industrialization contribute to the consolidation of free trade economic capitalism in which multinationals treat the world as one big market, coordinating complex economic operations across political boundaries. The presence of multinational corporations in less industrialized countries has had different consequences. On the one hand, it has helped spread the values, products, and consumptions of the developed world. On the other hand, it has contributed to a reinforcement of neocolonialism, economic disparity, and inequality. Multinational corporations are among the primary beneficiaries of economic liberalism. Growing openness and national markets and increased economic integration allow corporations to move goods, capital, and technology more fluidly and more intensively. As a consequence of the disparities and anxieties triggered by the failures of liberal democracy, the world has seen the emergence of new social movements around the planet. Human rights and social reform movements had advocated for the dispossessed and proposed solutions for millions of people's grievances around the planet. Activists have increasingly looked beyond national borders to tackle global problems together. Movements for women's rights, nuclear disarmament, environmental protection, and climate change all had become the focus of both local and international efforts. The contemporary world is full of complexities and contradictions. The big lessons of modern history is that, confronted with the possible destruction of the planet, humanity needs to work together to guarantee a better future for all. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.